Hello, this is Megha teacher. Today we will be doing lesson number 5, natural disaster, and the first part of this chapter. Now we will be doing this chapter with the help of a PPT. Now here, natural disaster. On 12th March 2011, Krishna saw the picture of a tsunami in the newspaper. After reaching school, she asked her class teacher, "Sir, I read the news about tsunami in the newspaper. How does a tsunami occur?" Sir replied, "Natural disasters are of two types. Now, disaster like earthquake, tsunami, and volcano occur due to the changes in the interior part of the earth. Now, these disasters occur why? Because of the changes in the interior part of the earth. Whereas, disasters like flood, cyclone, forest fire, and drought, etc. occur due to changes on the surface of the earth. So, these things occur, these disasters occur why? Because of the changes on the surface of the earth. Now we will cover the earthquake part. The weaker upper crust of the earth suddenly experience tremors either due to collision of the plates. Either these plates are moving against each other, then this is called plates collide. And for that reason, the earthquake take place. And or due to the tremendous pressure, if the plates are moving towards each other, or against each other, then the earthquake takes place. Or due to the tremendous pressure in the interior part of the earth, if there is lot of pressure in the interior part of the earth, then also earthquake takes place. Waves or tremors of earthquake originates from its hypocenter. So where do it originate? At this hypocenter, which is deep down below the surface of the earth. Such sudden shaking or trembling is known as earthquake. Earthquakes are created from the epicenter during the process of an earthquake, and from its epicenter it can be felt. Earthquake occur due to internal disturbance of the earth. And why does the earthquake take place? Because of the internal disturbance of the The wave of earthquake spreads outward from the epicenter, and these are the waves which can be felt at the time of the earthquake. It flows outwards. The point on the surface of the earth exactly above the hypocenter is known as the epicenter. So which place is considered as the epicenter? Above the hypocenter. The intensity of earthquake is felt the maximum around the epicenter, and where you will experience the intensity of the earthquake nearby the epicenter. The intensity of the earthquake decreases as we move away from the epicenter. The effect of an earthquake depends on the intensity of the earthquake. We can measure the intensity of the earthquake and know its point of origin and hypocenter with the help of the seismograph, and with the help of the seismograph you can also measure the intensity of the earthquake and also could easily make out the origin of the earthquake. There are three main reasons for the occurrence of an earthquake. Earthquake caused by volcanic eruption. So this is the first cause why the earthquake take place, because of the volcanic eruption. Second is earthquake caused by strike or slip fault. Strike or slip fault, when the plates are moving against each other. Earthquake caused by subduction in an active subduction zone. So this is called the active subduction zones, where the two plates are connected with each other. Either they are overlapping, or volcanic eruption inside the sea or on the land, or if they are overlapping on each other. So these are the three causes which led to the earthquake. So this is where I rest my video. and in the second part of the video we will meet. Till then, goodbye.